Hello friends, this is a very serious video. I have a message for all of you that concerns the very geometry underlying our daily lives, and it must be heard. So let's get to it. While aloof in my ivory tower, it came to my attention that some pink bipedal primates, known colloquially as humans, believe this wonderful oblate spheroid that we're all stuck to is, in fact, a habitable pancake drifting through the endless void. I was quite shocked by this line of reasoning originally and was simply going to write it off as another crank conspiracy hypothesis. However, the seemingly large numbers of people claiming that the Earth is indeed flat caused me to investigate. At the outset, I just have to ask, there is so much evidence demonstrating that the Earth is spherical, how could you possibly believe it's flat? Flat Earth proponents, correctly called flurfers, reply, "My good lad, name one piece of evidence for a round Earth." So I do. I point out the example Cool Hard Logic references in his debunking Flat Earth video, involving flying commercial planes from Australia to South Africa. I explain that planes couldn't fly from Australia to South Africa, or vice versa if the Earth were flat, because the planes don't have the necessary fuel requirements. The planes also don't fly over Asia, which would theoretically make the trip shorter on a flat Earth. Already, the flat Earth is dead. Hold on. Wait a minute. I've just been informed that airline companies are part of the conspiracy to push the globe Earth. Okay, strike the evidence I just entered from the record. Let's go another route. What about the astronauts in space who can directly witness the curvature of the Earth? Oh? They're part of the conspiracy too? Well, alright. But what about how we wouldn't stick to the Earth if it were flat, since there's no gravitational center? The flurfers respond, "But weight is what allows us to stick to the Earth." You counter, "We can't have weight if there's no gravity. After all, we derive mass by dividing weight by gravity." Wait, the physicists are also part of the conspiracy? Something about a blood ritual. Okay. Well, what about the fact that people go to Antarctica, like paleontologist Dr. Julia Clark, and can see that the continent doesn't form an ice wall around the world? Everyone who goes to Antarctica is part of the conspiracy? Well, why don't flurfers just go to Antarctica to see for themselves? Oh, there's a UN travel ban preventing people from going there? But the UN website doesn't say there's a travel ban to Antarctica. Wait, the UN is part of the conspiracy too? What about the people who take pictures from the top of Mount Everest and show that the Earth is spheroid? They're part of the conspiracy too? What about the fact that you can't see some constellations on certain parts of Earth? People who use telescopes are part of the conspiracy too? What about how the sun moves in a uniform rate all over the Earth and that the Earth casts a circular shadow on the moon during a lunar eclipse, both of which would be impossible on a flat Earth? I can't believe it! The sun and the moon are also part of the conspiracy. Well, faithful viewers, I don't know what to tell you. Everyone is part of the conspiracy. I might be the only innocent one left, and it's only a matter of time before the UN, NASA physicists, paleontologists, telescope users of the world, sun and moon, come for me to force me to tell all of you that the Earth is round. Goodbye, and trust no one.